Manchester United came to Anfield and they were humbled, they were humiliated, and they were destroyed. Let's get into the player ratings. How's it going, guys and girls? As I said, Manchester United have just lost 7-0 to Liverpool. If you've been living under a rock, welcome to the newsflash. That's what happened on the weekend, Sunday at 4:30. It was a beautiful time. I cannot believe that you missed it. But yeah, overall, I would have to say it was a really, really good performance from Liverpool. Who can deny it? In the first half, it was an even contest. And in the second half, we just blitzed them. I've been saying Ten Hag is amazing at in-game management. Well, I don't know what he did in that one, because he well and truly... it. But yeah, even still, really good from Liverpool. Great to see. Klopp obviously made the right decisions, which I'm great to do. And let's get into the player ratings, you know, because everyone played well and I want to talk about each of them individually. So, of course, as we always do, kicking it off in net with Alisson. I've given him a match rating of 8. Now, there's not too much that I can say about Alisson's performance, other than the fact that he didn't do anything wrong. The defence in front of him was great. He had a couple of chances at him, a couple of good saves. There was one really good shot early on from Antony, which Alisson saved brilliantly. But other than that, it was a pretty quiet game. Rashford, obviously, wasn't really on form, didn't really fire. I put that down to our two centre-backs having an absolutely insane game between them. But yeah, Alisson, you know, he did what he needed to do and kept a clean sheet. So, 8 for Alisson. And I've given the same rating to Trent Alexander-Arnold. I thought he was decent defensively. There was one beautiful tackle he made. It may have been offside in the build-up anyway, so it wouldn't matter. But the way he tackled Rashford, oh, it was beautiful. It was great to see. It showed how much passion he has in a game like this, which is always what you want. Overall, you know, I didn't think he performed too bad. There wasn't too much attacking from him. I think it more came from just the front three, which is on fire. And in the midfield played well as well, you know. But yeah. Overall, just a solid all-round performance from Trent, and I gave him an 8. I've given Konate a 9, and that might seem quite high, but I just think the way that Manchester United have been playing this season, especially since the World Cup, and Rashford in particular, they have been so lethal. And the fact that Konate and Van Dijk both silenced them completely, they couldn't get through, barely had a chance, apart from one miles offside header from Casemiro, you know, that just shows how solid Konate has been and how solid Van Dijk is as well on that fact. I'll get to Van Dijk in a minute. But yeah, Konate coming back into this Liverpool team has made a massive difference. And it is just so good to see us performing how we should, smacking United into the ground. And Konate was a big part of that. Like I said, Van Dijk, you know, very similarly to Konate. I can't really say too much different. Just so solid, so good defensively. He's pinging passes left and right again. It's wonderful to see. His defensive composure is amazing. Every time Rashford tried running through, Van Dijk snuffed him out wide if he needed to. If not, it was Konate doing it on the other side. It's just brilliant to see, wasn't it? Everyone enjoyed it, I think. Did any of you not enjoy it? Man United fans, probably. Everyone else is loving it. I know they are. And yeah, Konate gets himself, no, Van Dijk, sorry, gets himself a 9 as well. Given Andy Robertson a match rating of 8, I think maybe it's harsh, maybe it's not, I don't know. Same as Trent, I sort of just went before. I think, you know, the centre-backs were really dominant, the full-backs were good. 8 is still very high, people. Let's not bear that out, get that out of our mind. So yeah, given Robertson, just like Trent, a very good rating of 8. You know, he did everything that he needed to down that left side. Dominant as always. Good assist for Cody Gakpo. And yeah, it was really nice to see. Just, oh God, the defence was brilliant today. The midfield was solid. You could see 7s all round. And the attack was beautiful. Like I said, the midfield, 7s all round. I have given Fabinho a 7. I thought, maybe that's even being a bit harsh. Just maybe a bit harsh on Fabinho, I don't know. He was really good at winning the ball back. Really good challenges, high pressing. He looked better than he looked like the Casemiro on the pitch, can't lie. And Casemiro was on the pitch, so that says something, doesn't it? He was really good, just kept winning that ball back, couldn't let Man United through. First half, especially, you know, really good high press. And yeah, can't complain about Fabinho today, which is rare. Well done, Fabinho. You get a 7. And I've given Harvey Elliott a match rating of 8. Now, yeah, I think that's deserved. He was really good, really solid. I didn't want to go too high on all the midfield because you've got to give the match rating of higher numbers to the strikers as well. But yeah, I thought the midfield was really solid today and Harvey Elliott was a big part of that back and forth, running the game on the attacking front, you know. Just very good at coming in. There was a lot of space given to him by Man United and he used that space. Don't know what kind of game plan that is because maybe they thought, oh, he's not the main threat. But you saw when he's got the ball, he can certainly do things. And yeah, well played, Harvey Elliott. Speaking of sevens earlier, I've given the same thing to a Jordan Henderson. I think he was quite good in the midfield today, to be nice. You know, did well, didn't do anything really wrong. So I was just chugged in that midfield. It was really nice to see you having press on that left-hand side of the midfield as well, which was nice. Normally Henderson played on the right and there's not much press from there, but with Robertson and Henderson both playing on that left side, it was really, really solid. I really liked it. Just felt like there was just a presence at all times on the left side, and we dominated down that side. And obviously Gakpo got his goal from the left-hand side in the first half, which just really shows, you know, that first half domination. Second half, it just got taken away from United, and that was that, really. Now we move on to the good bit, which is, of course, the strike force. I've been looking forward to ranking these all day, all game. Now, I've only given one player a 10 in this game, and that might seem a bit harsh, but, you know, it's one of these front three. And starting off Cody Gakpo, I'm giving him a 9. Now, I loved Cody Gakpo's performance. I thought he was really solid. Just showed everyone what he's worth, and just the best bit of part as well. It's United wanted him. He came to us, he chose us, and then absolutely tore him apart. It was brilliant. A 9 for Cody Gakpo. His first goal, lovely finish, lovely cut inside. And the second goal, oh my God, that he scored. Oh, that little dink over De Gea. It reminded me of Luis Suarez. That's who that reminded me of. Just the composure to finish from that angle in such a style. Beautiful from Gakpo. And yeah, very close to getting a 10, I would say, but just I had to give it to someone else. And that person who I had to give it to was Mohamed Salah! Of course, I mean, who else? Sorry to those of people who had headphones on, but oh my God, Salah, what a game. I'm going to start off with my favourite moment from Salah, which wasn't that beautiful strike on his weaker foot, but it was making Martinez look like an absolute fool. Falling all over on his arse or whatever for Gakpo's second goal. It was beautiful to see Salah do that to him because I don't like him. I do not like Martinez at all. But seeing Salah do that to him just made me so, so happy. Let me know down below in the comments if that made you happy too, because that was probably my highlight of the game if I had to pick one. But yeah, just talking about Salah's rest of his performance, I mean, great finish, great, you know, the second goal was easy, but the first goal, what an amazing finish, 2 assists as well. Mohamed Salah, match winner 10, man of the match, brilliant from you. And lastly, we have got Darwin Nunez on the starting lineup. I thought he was very solid. He had 2 goals. Can't really complain. Showed his aerial dominance. I know the first one wasn't too hard of a chance, but it wasn't easy. He came at him fast and he composed himself, finished it well. And found the space in the box as well, which is very important. And then on the second chance, oh my God, what a beautiful header. I mean, it was just, he showed the world what he can do. That's what I said before the game. Show them what you can do. That's what I've been saying about Darwin Nunez, and he's showing it, and people might be starting to get a little bit scared. Because Darwin Nunez is starting to score. And, you know, it's just really good to see. Happy days, eh? On to the subs. Now, I've just given the subs an overall rating of 7. I think Bobby Firmino may be a bit higher on that scale. Diego Jota maybe was a 6. I don't think he was amazing. He could have probably scored. Maybe he should have had a penalty. I don't know. Who really cares, to be honest. But it was 7-0 up. Oh, what an 8! But still, yeah. I think, you know, it's a fair ranking to say 7 between all the subs that came on. They did their job. Firmino got a goal. It was lovely to see Bobby Dazzler scoring a beautiful goal. And it made me very happy, of course, because it's sad to see him go. But again, he's still scoring and giving his all. And I bet that was a big moment for him. It probably felt like the most lovely goal out of all of them. But yeah, overall, I've given a rating of a 7 to the subs. That's going to do it, guys. I mean, oh my God, what an insane game. I mean, it's hard to put it into words because it was just so unreal. Everyone performed brilliantly. It was a great team performance. We made Manchester United look stupid. And that is exactly what we want, you know. So yeah, overall, happy days for all Liverpool fans. If you have enjoyed this video, don't forget to leave a like. Subscribe if you're new. And if you made it this far, you should be a subscriber already. Let me know in the comments down below. Say Operation Bananas if you did. Peace.